Hi, this is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. Today we're going to look at Loom. It's going to be a quick video, going to show you exactly how the technology works. It's a free tool, and Phil Longwell is going to run this session because he knows the technology much better than I do. Let's get straight into the videos.
Okay, in order to get the Loom desktop app, you need to type in Loom into Google. This will come up with these options, and I would click on the desktop app. Otherwise, it's going to take you to the Google Chrome plugin. And if you haven't used Loom before, you'll need to download this for PC. And that will download the setup file onto your computer. Click on Finish Installing when that's done. Open up your Downloads folder, and you'll need to click on Run. Okay, and once you've installed, you should get a desktop app that looks like this, and a window, a dialog box, which asks you to either log in or to sign up. You can log in with the Google account, or you can use an email. I've already signed up for this, so I'm just going to log in now with my email and the password, which I created. And once you have logged in, you will get the desktop app, and this is what the desktop app looks like. The default option is to have screen and camera, and you can see the camera has appeared in the top left hand, bottom left hand corner of the screen, or you can have the option to have screen only with no camera bubble, or camera only. For the purposes of this demonstration, I'm going to use screen and camera. Your microphone's input, in my case, will be a USB headset, but you can choose which microphone input you have on this drop-down menu here. And Loom will decide what your automatic pixel recording size is going to be. Bear in mind that I'm using the pro version of Loom, which you can get on a 14-day trial. And that basically means that you can record in 4K high definition, but on a basic version you wouldn't be able to do that. And the other thing that you can't see on here is, because I'm using Windows, you can't see a choice of window and custom size, which is currently only available for Mac users, but will be available to Windows users soon. So let's try a recording. So I'm going to bring up a web page such as this, and I'm going to click on Start Recording. And then you get a very short countdown, 2, 1, 0, and then once that ding ding, you hear the ding ding going on, and that's the indication that the recording has started. And then everything on my screen, as well as the camera and my microphone, is going to be recorded. So if I move away from that page and onto a different page, it's going to record that. And over on the left hand side, you've got the stop button, so you can stop the recording anytime, or you can pause the recording if you want to just take a breath and then carry on, or you can delete the recording straight from here if you're not happy with it. The other thing that you can do in the Pro edition is you can draw on the screen. So if I click on here, I can click a color such as this, and then I can draw on the screen if I want to draw attention to anything on the screen, which will also appear on the recording. But as I say, that's only available on the Pro edition, which you can get on a 14-day trial.
Hi, this is just a really quick reminder. If you want to keep up with all the videos on the YouTube channel, then please subscribe. You can click on the subscribe button down here, and also make sure that you click on the bell, and that way you'll be updated when new videos are added up onto the channel. Thank you.
But on the basic version, you wouldn't get that. Once you're happy with the recording, once you finish your recording, you press the stop. And then automatically you'll hear ding ding, which says that the recording has been stopped, and it will open up in your browser your folders, your account, your folders with your recordings. So it gives me a desktop recording with today's date, and then I have a number of options which I can use to share this, trim this, or do other things like make a comment on this recording. If I play this recording back, the ding ding going on, and that's the indication that the recording has started, and then everything on my screen, as well as the camera and my microphone, is going to be recorded. So if I move away from that page and onto a different page, it's going to record that. And over on the left hand side, you've got the stop button, so you can stop the recording anytime, or you can pause the recording if you want to just take a breath and then carry on, or you can delete the recording straight from here if you're not happy with it. The other thing that you can do in the Pro edition is you can draw on the screen. So if I click on here, I can click a color such as this, and then I can draw on the screen if I want to draw attention to anything on the screen. Once you've got your recording, you can immediately delete the video if you're not happy with it. You can download the video, or as I say, you can share it, or you can just use this copy link up here, and then you can copy that into another browser or into a social media or however you want to share it. That's a basic view of the Loom desktop application. Hope you enjoyed it.
Okay, I hope you found that video useful. Thank you to Phil Longwell for producing that video for me. If you want more videos on using technology, then please come to teachertrainingvideos.com. You'll see lots of different technologies at the top of the screen that you can access, lots of videos. They're all free, and there's also some topic-based material below here. If you'd like to keep up with my work, there's really two things that I can suggest you do. Number one, sign up to the newsletter. That way you'll get updated on all the latest videos. You'll also get updated on any webinars, any short courses, and even sometimes I have special offers on software. And then slowly growing now is the YouTube channel. I think we're up to around about 6,500 followers. So please follow me on YouTube, and that way you'll also keep up with all the latest videos that have been added up onto the YouTube channel. And thank you very much. And finally, if you'd like to continue your studies, I've provided you with three links to three sets of videos that I think you might find interesting. And thank you very much.